pharmacology students, this is Dr. Herndon. This is the first of two videos on the review of medical calculations. Our learning objectives for today are to recognize and be able to use different systems of measurement. You should be able to convert metric units of measurement. You should be able to convert from one system of measurement to another system of measurement. And you should understand when decimal points should be used and when they should not be used when you're writing down and recording drug doses or drug amounts. Okay, so there are three systems of measurement which I'm going to be talking about here. The metric system, which is probably the most commonly used, the apothecary system, and the household system. All three of these have different units that measure weight, volume, and length. The metric system is probably the most commonly used system of measurement in calculation of drug dosages and fluid rates and constant rate infusions. We often will use these units for weight, the kilogram, the gram, the milligram, and the microgram. Keep in mind that different units of metric measurements differ from one another by power of 1,000. So for instance, a kilogram is greater than a gram, and a gram is greater than a milligram, and a milligram is greater than a microgram. And they're by 1,000. So here, 1 kilogram is equivalent to 1,000 grams, and 1 gram is equivalent to 1,000 milligrams. And down here, 1 milligram is equivalent to 1,000 micrograms. So we can use these conversions when we are working with a metric system. Down here, the liter and the milliliter are volume measures. Again, same thing with liter and milliliter right here. 1 liter is equivalent to 1,000 milliliters. And I want you to look down at the bottom here, the cc. The cc stands for cubic centimeter. It just so happens that within 1 cubic centimeter is held 1 milliliter of fluid or water. Okay, so these two are, you'll often see them used as equivalencies, and sometimes you'll see syringes labeled in cc's instead of mils. A 1 mil or 1 cc is equivalent to 1 gram. If you are confused and you don't know off the top of your head all these conversions, it's perfectly fine to use a common conversion table, and I've posted one on Canvas, though you can find them on the web anywhere. If you have a favorite version or something, that's perfectly fine. You can also go on to Plum's Veterinary Drugs, and in the appendix, you'll find a conversion chart. Okay, there's two ways to convert metric units. The first way is to use a conversion factor, which is what we kind of just did. So here's an example. If we need to convert 3,000 milligrams to grams, so we want to know how many grams is equivalent to 3,000 milligrams. 3,000 milligrams, I know that I'm going to have to cancel out my milligrams and that my answer is going to be in grams. So I'm going to put that on top because I know that these are going to cancel out. So the question becomes, what's your conversion factor right here? You can look this up. It so happens that 1,000 milligrams is equivalent to 1 gram. So our problem, this one's kind of easy because we can just cancel out our zeros right here, right? So 3 times 1 divided by 1 equals 3. And there's our units in grams. Different way to do metric conversions are by using this little system of arrows right here. Some people like this, and this helps you. It's a visual to help you determine which direction you're going to move your decimal point in. When you're converting and you're moving the decimal point, you're going to move your decimal point 3 places because remember, these units differ by a power of 1,000. Let's do an example. For the microgram, you can use MCG or μg. I like to use MCG, and I'll tell you why, because the mu is nice, right? But every once in a while, it can look strange. Maybe somebody doesn't write it right, and it may actually end up looking more like milligrams, okay? So I like to use 3 letters for microgram myself. Let's do this example. So the question reads here, I need 0.5 grams of drug A, but I have 250 milligram tablets. Well, it's not really asking us anything, but what I can see here is I have milligrams on one side and grams on the other side. How am I gonna do any kind of dose calculation? I'm gonna have to use the same units. Remember, when you're doing dose calculations, you need your units to be the same. Okay, so I'm going to convert grams to milligrams. We're going to milligrams, so here's our arrow. We know that grams is greater than milligrams, which means we're going to move our decimal point 3 places to the right. Let me write this out down here with more zeros so you can see. Okay, there's 0.5 grams, but I just added some zeros. So if we're going to move this decimal point right here 3 places to the right, we're going to go from here, 1, 2, 3, and it's going to end up right there. So our answer is going to be 500 milligrams. So 0.5 grams equals 500 milligrams. All right, let's try one more to is for practice. Again, this isn't really asking you to make it, to do a conversion, but you can see if you need 300,000 micrograms of a drug, but you have 150 milligram tablets, you're going to have to get your units the same so you can work with this in a formula. So I'll convert 300,000 micrograms to milligrams. And we're going to use these arrows. Which one do we use? We're going to use this one between micrograms and milligrams. And milligrams are greater than micrograms. Micrograms are less than milligrams or smaller than. So we're going to have our arrow this direction. So this in this case, we're going to move our decimal point three places to the left. 1, 2, 3. And it's going to go right there. So our answer is 300 micrograms. All right, here's the practice problem for you. Pause the video, try the problem, come back, and I'll go over it. Okay, the question reads, how many micrograms are there in 3 milligrams? Let's start by writing down 3 milligrams. You can do it either way, however you want to do it. I'm going to do it using a conversion factor, so I know that I have to have my milligrams on the bottom to cancel them out. And I'm trying to convert to micrograms right there. So I know that in 1 milligram, there are 1,000 micrograms. And you can get this from a chart. That's fine. Some cancel 3 times 1,000, 3,000 micrograms. All right, here's the problem for you. Pause the video, try it, and then when you come back, I'll go over the question. All right, I hope you tried it. This is one of my daughter's little guinea pigs. Her name is Misty. She's very, very cute. So the question is, how many kilograms does a 230-gram guinea pig weigh? So let's do it this way. How about if we just use the arrows? So we want to know how many kilograms equivalent to 230 grams. So I know that a kilogram is larger than a gram. So my decimal point will move three places to the left. Here, we're going to start here. 1, 2, 3, 0.23 kilograms. The other way to do it would have been to use dimensional analysis or conversion factor. 1,000 grams equals 1 kilogram, and then you do the math, cancel, 100 into 23 goes 0.23 times, okay? The second system of measurement that we're going to be using, and you will see used a little bit in pharmaceutical calculations, is called the apothecary system. It's the grain, which is the basic unit of weight. A grain just happens to be equivalent to 1 grain of wheat. This shows you how old this system is. And a grain just happens to be equivalent to about 65 milligrams. Not exactly. When we're writing grain, make sure you put the GR, grain is GR, before the number. This is important right here. You can also use fractions when we're looking at grain. So grain 1/2 means a half of a grain. So a half of a grain would be half of 65 milligrams. The dram is a volume unit of measurement that's equivalent to 4 mils. The minim is equal to a drop. The fluid ounce here is a unit of measurement which equals 30 mils or 2 tablespoons. So again, you don't have to memorize all these conversions. You can look them up on a chart. Okay, and the third system of measurement we have here that you'll see used is called the household system. And you can see I have some measuring spoons here because anybody who's worked in the kitchen has used the household system. This first one here, you're going to use this all the time when we're doing fluid drip rates. The drop, which is abbreviated GTT. 1 mil has 15 standard size drops in it, but we have different size fluid administration sets which are calibrated to different drop sizes. Okay, so we have drop sets that have little tiny drops, so there's more drops per mil, and then bigger drops, fewer drops per mil. Down here, the teaspoon and the tablespoon are very commonly used measurements. Just so happens that a tablespoon is equal to 15 mils and a teaspoon is equal to 5 mils. You can look that up. And then down here, very important, the household system uses the pound to measure weight. Okay, you can see the pound is most commonly abbreviated LB, but sometimes you'll see hashtag used. The hashtag is used to record pounds. I use the hashtag a lot when I'm writing pounds. So if you see me writing something like this, 20 hashtag, it means 20 pounds, okay? The conversion from metric to household system of weight measure is 1 kilogram is equivalent to 2.2 pounds. You guys are gonna use this all the time because say you are converting a weight from pounds to kilograms, 2.2 pounds here is equivalent to 1 kilogram. So the problem becomes weight in pounds divided by 2.2 equals the weight in kilograms. It's important that you always confirm what units you're using, either for the pet's weight, is it pounds or is it kilograms, and for the medication strengths that you're using. You want to make sure that you confirm units before you start doing your calculations. Here's another point, death by decimal point. It's kind of an ugly sounding phrase, but the point to make here is that you need to double check your decimal places. If you are off, if you've converted incorrectly, so let's say you were supposed to give 0.025 mils of something and instead you're giving 0.25 mils of something, well, suddenly you're giving 10 times the amount of a drug. Depending on the drug, you know, that could have very serious consequences. Okay, so it's important to check and double check and triple check and ask somebody else, ask a senior vet tech or ask the veterinarian to check your math. Very important. Another word about decimals, and this is an important point right here, you need to know where to put your decimal point and where, when to use a zero and when not to use a zero. If you're writing a value less than one, say you're writing 0.25 milligrams, you always want to have your placeholder zero in front of your decimal point, okay? Otherwise, it could potentially get washed away by a drop of water, or it could end up being scribbled and you don't see it. Because let's say all of a sudden a drop of water comes and just washes it away. Well, suddenly you have a very different drug dose. You started out needing 0.25 milligrams, your decimal point got wiped away, and then suddenly you're recording a dose that's 100 times larger. That could have devastating consequences. Likewise, if you're writing a whole number, let's say you're writing a whole number, 25 milligrams, you don't need to put your decimal and placeholder zero afterwards. That's not necessary. You could end up losing this decimal point somehow. Maybe it's scribbled, maybe it's in pencil, and it got washed away. Who knows? Or it just doesn't show up that well. And all of a sudden, you have something that's very different than what you need and what you started with. Okay, so you need 25 milligrams of a drug, and all of a sudden you're recording in an animal's medical record that you need 250 milligrams of a drug. Big difference. So be careful with your zeros and your decimals. Okay, conversions. I have put a conversion table on Canvas. You can also find conversion tables. There's one in the Plums Veterinary Drug online in the appendix. You can find them all over the internet too. If you have some kind of favorite chart or you like have an app or something like that, that's perfectly fine. But you should be able to convert between metric units, what we were just working on, and you also should be able to easily convert between different units of measurement. Here are some more common ones, like converting between tablespoons and mils, or teaspoons to mils, or vice versa, between ounces and mils, grains to milligram. This is grains over here. Grains to milligrams, milligrams to grains, pounds to kilogram. We do that all the time. Again, you're going to need a conversion chart. Some of these you'll eventually memorize. All right, so let's practice. The first one is asking 20 mils is how many teaspoons? I've given you the conversion here so you don't have to look it up. I'm going to do it this way. 20 mils, I know that if I put mils on the bottom, I can cancel out my units. There it is right here. 5 mils is equivalent to 1 teaspoon. Cancel, cancel. 20 divided by 5 equals 4, and our units are in teaspoons. Here are two practice problems for you. Pause the video, try them. I've given you the conversions. When you restart the video, I'll go over the answers. Okay, let's go over the answers. First question asks, half a grain is equivalent to how many milligrams? I've given you the conversion. 1 grain equals 65 milligrams. Again, easy to set up, knowing what units you need to end up with. Whoops, I'm going to put grain down here, not here. Otherwise, it'll look like gram. Milligrams up on the top. 65 milligrams is equivalent to 1 grain. Cancel units. So the problem becomes 65 times a half, or 65 divided by 2, which equals 32.5 milligrams. Second problem, 45 milliliters is equivalent to how many ounces? Here's your conversion. Same thing. I'm going to put mils on the bottom so I can cancel. Ounces on the top. 30 mils is equivalent to 1 ounce. Cancel units. So this problem becomes 45 times 1 divided by 30, which equals 1.5 ounces. All right, we're finished with part one of medical calculations. Go ahead and take the calculations quiz number one that is in the calculations module on Canvas. Make sure you have some sort of conversion chart that you have available while you're doing this. Okay, when you're finished with that, then go ahead and watch part two of medical calculations, and then there is a quiz number two that's associated with that. Thanks.